Very good morning, children. How are you? I hope you are all fine. Here I am fine. Today again, one more part of a lesson. We'll start now. So we are in the lesson Matter Around Us. So we have to start part G of this lesson. So once again, just I will recollect whatever the activities you have done in this lesson. So your first activity is to identify definite shape and volume of a liquid. You have taken different shapes and filled with the same liquid. Then you observe what is that? A liquids have a definite shape and definite volume. So once again, we have to start with one more activity. What is that? Do the gases have a definite shape and a fixed volume? For that, we have discussed about CNG and different CNG tanks, the CNG fuel station and the CNG cylinder in the cars and all. So this is one more activity related to gases have a definite shape and a fixed volume. So observing the compressibility of different materials, we have done an activity where we have taken a syringe in that solid, liquid and gas we have taken, and we observed the compressibility of all the three states of matter. This is the activity we have covered. Related to diffusion of gases, we have taken agarbatti, how this fumes of agarbatti got mixed with the air. This is the things what we have studied related to diffusion. And we have observed the diffusion of a liquid. We have where we have taken a liquid water, in that we have dropped a few drops of ink. Then how this ink got diffused in the liquid water. And related to diffusion, that is solids and liquid, I have shown the copper sulfate which is in a crystalline form, that is related to solid. And I have shown a potassium permanganate where that is also in a crystalline, that in the form of a solid got mixed with the liquid water, where this got diffused. So in this way we have studied solids and liquids diffusion. And one more activity which is related to lab activity, I have shown a diffusion of two gases, one is ammonia and the other one is HCl, using a long glass test tube, how this lighter gas diffuses faster than the heavier gas. I hope you have remembered this activity related to diffusion of two gases related to ammonia and HCl gas. So here related to how small the particles of matter, here I have taken a solution of potassium permanganate. I may diluted of this solution 4 to 5 times, and few children of 8th standard have sent a pictures after doing this activity with the colored water or a Dettol or whatever you have taken and sent me the pictures. I hope you recollected this activity, so which is related to how small are the particles of matter. And next comes, there exists a space between the particles where we have taken a salt or a sugar and added in water, so that 1 or 2 spoons when you add, the level of the water will not rise. If you add more than the more amount of salt or sugar, the level of water rises. So in this activity we have learned there exists a space between the water particles and the solid particles. So where the solid particles go and occupy the space between the liquid particles. I hope this also you have recollected the activity now. So force of attraction between the particles of matter, here we have taken a piece of chalk piece as well as a piece of iron nail. You cannot break a piece of iron nail, but you can break the piece of chalk piece. From this it is clear that force is not equally strong in all the states of matter, even though it is in the solid matter. So I hope you have recollected this activity also. How diffusion takes place in all the three states of matter depending upon the packing of particles of solid, liquid and gases. In solids, we find a less space between the particles of matter, so diffusion will be less, whereas when it comes to liquid, the particle interparticle distance in liquids is more as compared to solid. So we find more diffusion in liquids as compared to solid. When it comes to gas, the interparticle distance is more than the liquid, so we can find diffusion in gases is more as compared to solid. In this way, we have learned the diffusion process in all the three states of matter. And coming to the activity of melting, and the last part we have learned about melting, how the melting has taken place. So what is melting process? The conversion of a solid into a liquid, where whatever the amount of heat energy that is used up by the solid particles to convert its state from a solid state to liquid state without increasing in its temperature, or you can tell that in such a way the melting point is not increasing more than 0 degrees Celsius. For ice, we have recently done this activity where all the amount of heat energy that is taken by the solid particles, it is used up by the solid particles to convert its state from a solid to liquid in the form of latent heat of fusion. I hope this all you have recollected. Once again, all the videos what you have seen, once again you please observe, children, because within one or two classes we will start our revision and you have to write your CT also. Please, once again, you rewatch the videos up to now in this lesson. Because of that, I have started from starting whatever the activities we have done till now. So in the class, last class, we have learned change of a state from a solid to liquid, which is a melting process. In today's class, we learn change of a state from a liquid to gas, that is boiling. So actually, this is the continuation process after melting. So during the process of melting, all the solid is converted into liquid. Still, if you give more amount of heat energy, what is happening inside the liquid, that we are going to study today. That is related to boiling process. So water, on supplying heat energy to the water, the kinetic energy of the water particles increases and therefore they move faster. So at certain temperature, while you are supplying the heat energy, the particles have enough energy to become free from the force of attraction among the particles which are in the liquid state. So then the liquid starts changing into gas. So the temperature at which a liquid starts boiling at the atmospheric pressure is known as its boiling point. So you have to remember, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. So once again, listen, what is happening here? When you supply heat to the liquid, I told the kinetic energy of the particles increases. So what happened? The interparticle distances between the liquid particles increases, thereby a force of attraction between the particles become weak. So ultimately, a stage is reached where the interparticle distances become so large so that the force of attraction holding the particles together are completely cut off. So at this stage, the particles become completely free to move about in the whole space available to them, and then the liquid starts boiling. So that is, the liquid changes its state to vapors. Either here vapor means, you have to remember, gaseous state. So I told, a melting point is the strength of force of attraction. Similarly, the boiling point is also a measure of strength of force of attraction between its constant particles. Higher the boiling point, stronger the force of attraction, you have to remember. So in the process of boiling, what actually is happening, where a liquid is converting into vapor, that we have to discuss in one of the experiment in the later part of the lesson. So actually, it is a continuation of the experiment of melting. So now all the ice is got melted to water. Now you find in the beaker you have a water of some quantity, and you have to place a glass rod in the beaker. First is the water. So what you have to do, continue the supply of heating the beaker with a low flame, and you have to note down the temperature when the water starts boiling. So keep on watching the thermometer reading till most of the water has vaporized. So you will observe the temperature remains constant during boiling or a change of state from liquid to gaseous state. So this all comes under latent heat of vaporization. So we have learned there latent heat of fusion, now latent heat of vaporization. So whatever the heat is used up in overcoming the force of attraction between the particles of a liquid during the change of a state from liquid to gas without increasing their kinetic energy. So since the kinetic energy of the particles does not increase, the temperature of the liquid also does not rise during the change of state. So this heat is observed without showing any rise in the temperature. It is called as latent heat of vaporization. Now the definition of latent heat of vaporization: the amount of heat energy that is required to change 1 kg of a liquid into vapors. Vapors means you have to remember here gaseous state at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is called latent heat of vaporization. So one more point you have to remember: at 100 degrees Celsius both water and steam exist together, but the particles of steam here means water vapor, at 100 degrees will have more energy as compared to the particles of water at the same temperature. Since during the change of state from water to steam, so much of heat energy which is equivalent to latent heat of vaporization has been observed here. So steam is more effective than boiling water for heating purpose. So next process is change of gaseous state to liquid state. That comes under condensation. So what is condensation? Now the process of changing a gas or a vapor into a liquid by cooling is called condensation. So listen, what happens during this condensation? So when a gas or a vapor is cooled by lowering its temperature, that means the kinetic energy of their constant particles decreases. Due to decrease in their kinetic energy, the particles start moving slowly. As the temperature is further lowered, the attractive forces pull the particles close together and the gas or water vapor, it tries to condense, that is a gas or water changing into a liquid. So that process is known as actually a condensation. Here you have to remember, whatever the heat energy in the form of latent heat of vaporization, the liquid water absorbed to convert into vapor. So whatever the heat energy it absorbed, so that much heat energy will be given out again, converting from a vapor state to a liquid state. Okay. And one more point you have to observe here: the burns caused by the steam are much more severe than those caused by the boiling water, because both of them are at same temperature, but the steam, which is at 100 degrees, has more amount of heat, which is equal to latent heat of vaporization, than the boiling water at 100 degrees Celsius. So when a steam at 100 degrees falls on your skin and condense to form water, it gives out energy than the boiling water at 100 degrees. That is the reason heat causes severe burns when a stream of water falls on your skin. So on the whole, we have to remember that one state of matter can be changed to another state of matter by absorbing or giving out heat energy. So whatever we have learned here in the two activities, that is melting process and the boiling process. In the melting process, solid is changed to liquid. In this boiling process, liquid is changed to gas on supply of heat. But some substances are there where where changes directly from solid state to gaseous state and vice versa without passing into liquid state. And that is related to sublimation. So this is related to sublimation you are going to study in the next class. Here this is ice. When you are supplying heat, it melt. Already I told you, melting and forming in the form of water. Again, if you supply heat, it evaporates and forms into steam. So again, the steam is condensed to water. Water is solidified to ice. So you have to remember the one more point here. Ice is directly converting into steam or vapor. That comes under sublimate process. Next, steam is directly converting into ice. That comes under deposition. So here one more diagram is there. Solid to liquid process melting. Liquid to gas is boiling. And a gas to liquid is condensation process. And a liquid to solid is also known as a freezing process. And this about this solid to gas sublimation and gas to solid is deposition. This all we did not learn about sublimation and deposition, but we have learned about melting, boiling, freezing and condensation. How it melts, evaporates, solidify, condense. This all we have done in all the last class and today's class also. I hope you have understood and remember this diagram in a short way. Solid to liquid is a melting, liquid to gas is a boiling process, and again gas to liquid condensation, liquid to freezing is liquid to solid is a freezing. Here we have to supply heat energy in both these cases. Here heat energy will be given out, then condensation takes place. Here also heat energy will be given out, freezing takes place. So like that you remember in a short way. Okay.